really big shoe tonight. Really big shoe tonight.
Really big shoe.
It's Saturday morning, dammit. Let's watch some cartoons.
Good morning, everybody. It's time for another really big episode of the Cartoon Retrocast, starring me, Jeremy, and that guy over there, Mike.
Sat on my mute button.
Sat on his mute button. Sounds sat like a it. Personal problem. Yeah. Good morning, everybody.
So we're not streaming.
It's streaming. I don't want to talk about streaming.
Are we streaming?
Oh, now you're breaking up.
Moppenstein.
You better turn that off because it's sucking up your internet bandwidth. That's just.
Oh boy. Well, it says offline. So.
Oh boy. All right, everybody. He's offline. My name. It could be your hacker name offline. When we make our hacker movie, mine would be V90. Get that reference.
V90.
So, hey, it's Cartoon Retrocast. You want to hear the old episodes? You go to cartoonretrocast.com. How many episodes are we up to now, Mike?
162.
162 episodes, at least an hour long. That's 162 hours. That's 65 days worth of audio, nonstop. Audio, Cartoon Retrocast.
It's not even to mention the after shows, which were like 40 episodes, 50 episodes strong.
Those were 2 or 3 hours long.
Which is another 2 days, yeah.
So 67 hours total. But that, yeah. You know, what keeps us going? I don't know what keeps us going. It's the...
Nothing. Nothing.
So if you want to support our show... And the upcoming really big contests and really big stuff that goes on. Go to patreon.com/cartoonretrocast and become a patron.
I'm just going to record us recording.
Oh, man.
My camera.
It looks like Mike's video is so awful right now. I told us, like, looking back in time.
Yeah. Real media. 1996.
I think that GoPro is sucking up your internet bandwidth.
1998? Oh. It's red. My thing just went red. Can you even still hear me? I can't even believe that you still hear me.
I always knew you were a dirty communist.
Can't even...
You'll get yours when Arnold Schwarzenegger turns up the heat. We got a really big contest going on, Mike. Really big. Is this the last...
Oh,
is this the last week? I think it's the last week.
Yep, this is the last week. So we're going to put our... Our phrase of pays, word of the day. I'm going to go ahead and say it's not necessarily going to be mandatory when we pick, because the show might only be out for like a day. But throw it in there. Why not? Right?
Yeah.
Can't even hear me anymore, can you?
I hear you. What's going on? What's up? Listening.
No.
You're talking.
So somewhere throughout the show, we'll give you the phrase of pays. Email that to us. I think only a couple people have emailed us the last phrase of pays. So, when it comes down to it, like, there's a chance that it might be between, like, a couple people.
Hold on, we're going to... I got to talk to Randy. Hello?
Hey.
Hey.
I wanted to let you know that I probably won't be coming over tonight.
Oh, that's okay. I'm doing my podcast. I'm recording it right now.
Really?
Yeah, say hi.
TFO, Randy.
Hey. Oh, my God.
Coming over tonight.
So
what time is it there?
We're eating Chinese, and then this irate lady comes in and starts, like, making such a fuss. And I actually, because I'm an idiot, I started talking back to her.
You started giving shit to the lady in the Chinese restaurant?
No, to the lady that came in being mean to the lady in the shop that works at the Chinese restaurant.
White lady, Randy?
I kind of recorded it.
You should have recorded. Put it on YouTube. Was it a white lady? Was it a Caucasian female?
Oh yeah, she and her husband was like all ashamed. His head was all down.
Oh, poor guy. Was her husband a white guy?
And I even told her. I told her your husband isn't saying anything because he knows you're wrong.
You said that to her.
Said it to the lady.
I'm rubbing off on you, Randy.
With her husband right there, too.
I know I'm going to get shot soon.
Now you know what it is. It's because you shaved off all your hair.
Wait, what?
It makes you tougher.
maybe.
None of that hair stealing all your testosterone. All right, I'm going to go back to recording this podcast.
All right, bye, guys.
Bye.
See ya.
See ya. Bye, Randy.
See, look at that. Randy's talking shit to people in Chinese food restaurants. I'm rubbing
you,
off on
you. You and Randy get real tough when there's old women involved.
It's old women and small children. You better watch out.
I got a story for you where you're rubbing off on people.
All right, let's hear it.
So I went on vacation.
Mm-hmm,
right?
Mm-hmm.
That's where I've been for the last week and a half.
Yep, much needed.
Went to the
vacation.
The beautiful island nation of Hawaii.
Mm-hmm. Talking some pigeon.
And what?
Talking some pigeon.
Talking some pigeon. I can't even do it. It's like impossible.
Oh, you're full
of
shit.
It just turns on when I'm talking to people that talk it. But when I'm talking to Jeremy, I'm all like, oh, you're going to the harbor with the...
Go to the science center.
Wolf.
Get some water.
Water. So anyway, we go there. And I'm in the hotel, right, in the lobby, and we're checking out of the hotel because we're going to go to a different island. And so my daughter's throwing a fit in the lobby of the hotel.
Your kid's making a lot of noise? Get the fuck out of here.
Kid's making a lot of noise.
Not your kid. You're by somebody else's kid.
No, my kid.
What? Right?
I know. It's crazy. So she's screaming, and I'm not there. And so my wife calls me, and she's like, come get your daughter right now. Hang up on me. I'm like, what the hell was that bullshit? So I go downstairs to, you know, I'm in the second floor, so I go downstairs to go get her. And she's like, pick her up and go to the car. So I'm like, all right. So I pick her up and I walk back through. So this is outside the lobby. Walk back through the lobby and some old bitch is like, stop it. Stop it. Stop it. And I turn to her and I'm like, are you talking to me? And she's like, no, I'm talking to her. And I'm like, shut up. What the hell?
You know what's funny?
What's wrong with you?
Is that...
That's what I'm saying is, and I told my wife this, I get tough when there's, you know, an old lady involved.
If it was some 6-foot-tall, like Samoan guy about 400 pounds...
He wouldn't have said nothing. That's the thing.
But if he did, you would have said, you'd have stuffed the sock in her mouth. Like, shut up. When I was a kid, something similar happened with me. This was a story that my parents related to me. We were at the Gunnings, and if you know, you go to the Gunnings was like tax return when you get your tax returns when you go to Gunnings. You don't go to Gunnings for like you go to McDonald's, man. It's a special occasion.
It's a restaurant.
So it's a restaurant, sit down restaurant. You have lobster and some seafood restaurant. And I was in there screaming. They were telling me I was screaming. And, you know, they were trying to console me. Like, they were like, Jeremy, you know, you gotta be quiet. And he says, the guy next to us leaned over in his chair and was like, Jeremy, shut up! And and they were like, you shut up? And you sat there quiet the whole rest of the the whole rest of the evening. So sometimes it works.
Yeah, but I was pissed because I thought she was talking to me. So then I got pissed. And then she said she wasn't talking to me, and then I told her to shut the fuck up anyway. I didn't say shut the fuck up. I said shut up.
You said please,
but loud, though. Like, in front of this big lobby full of a lot of people.
And they're like,
very fancy.
Everyone there is like, now we know where she gets it. Mm-hmm. Her father's a jerk, too.
But it's like, what is it with these people, man? Like,
was it a white lady?
Kids cry. Like, you just don't say anything.
Was it a white lady?
Yeah, as a white lady.
White people always feel like they gotta say something.
You don't think that some... Yeah, of course it was a white lady. Only white people are devils like that.
They get involved, but like...
White devils.
White people do feel like they can get involved. Like, I know what to do to fix this problem. That's why like so much of the world's fucked up. It's because white people thought, I know how to fix this. Let me get involved.
Trust me, if it was some North Korean lady, she wouldn't have been saying nothing.
North Korea. They'd have rubbed a little... was a VX agent on your daughter's face. that'll keep her quiet.
Isn't that the shit from The Rock?
No.
Remember that movie?
One with Sean Connery.
Yeah, Sean Connery. Like, what's that guy? Whoa, what? Why?
Nicolas Cage.
Nicolas Cage, right.
We called the dog Nicolas.
Yeah, they have VX gash in the missiles. Oh, are you the Rocket Man? Because you're the Rocket Man. You're like Elton John.
Okay. I hate Nicolas Cage. I will not sit through Nicolas Cage movies. I cannot do it. The last one I saw was Raising Arizona, and that was 1982 or something.
Yeah. I like Con Air, and I like The Rock.
What about Face Off?
Did not like Face Off. Did not like Face Off.
I thought it was going to be a hockey movie. It was not.
I thought it was one of the worst movies I've ever seen.
It was not a hockey movie. So we're having a really big contest. Randy interrupted us. Some old lady yelling at Mike's kids interrupted us. And here it is. This week, I didn't yell at anybody. I was the good one. Really big contest. Last week, enter to win. Nintendo Switch. So, Mike, what else did
Nintendo
you do?
Switch, Breath of the Wild, which I will be picking up. It's less than a week now.
March 3rd.
So Friday. I'll be picking it up on Friday. We're going to be doing a live show Friday night. Right, Jeremy?
Yeah.
I assume it's just going to be a show. I don't know if we're actually going to do the show. We'll just pick the winner for the Switch and then, I don't know, talk about it. I might fire it up and play it.
You know what else? You know, it's those we're not going to be emailing people. If you win, if you're a very big winner, you better be listening.
Nah, I'll even come on.
No. They got to hear it on show. They email us. Say,
I'll send out an email. Don't you worry about it.
F that, man. You should make them listen. It's the whole point.
But you should listen. You should listen so you can get that anticipation. Because if it's, you know.
Could be.
But you. So.
Well, you're lucky Mike's in charge. I'm going to email it. So you went on your really big vacation. Anything good happen besides yelling at little old ladies? Nice little.
By the way,
old
that's
ladies.
Our phrase of days. Old bitch.
Oh, come on! I couldn't use booger farts, but you can use old bitch.
Well, you just randomly pick booger farts. This is an actual story.
Was she?
No,
old?
Okay. We'll get to it. That's not it. That's not it. Don't message us that. So, yeah, lots of stuff happened on my vacation. Went to the beach, like, every day.
Beaches. Sons of beaches.
Got a lot of sun. Got a lot of sunburn. Got a lot of peeling.
A lot of beach-related things. A lot of... Do you smell like sunscreen a lot? A lot of that going on?
No, on sunscreen. That's for white people.
Yeah, but you got to put on your kids. Oh, you know what happened to me? I watched a Bob Marley documentary. So, you were talking pidgin, like, after I watched that Bob Marley, I was, like, speaking in Jamaican, like, with a Jamaican accent for, like, 2 hours afterwards. I couldn't shake it. Anyway.
You probably know more about Bob Marley than I do.
They were talking on, the documentary was made by his family, so you know it's a bullshit documentary. I mean, it's probably accurate to a point, but they left out all the bad shit. Anyway.
Yeah, that's the part where he murdered that guy.
Well, he was like, at one point, Bob Marley was married, and he was also with a Jamaican model, and he was also with a 16-year-old girl. And they said to the model, they were like, hey, did you know he was married? And she was like, no, I didn't know he was married, man, but that's a Western idea. You know, a white man can handle more than one woman, but Bob Marley can handle more than one woman.
Marley had 2.5 women, like that show.
But
except
so,
for I don't know that show.
What I didn't know was that Bob Marley's father was white. That's no big deal. Mm. Except for,
I didn't know that.
He got the melanoma. He's got cancer on his toe. And the lady goes, because everybody teased him for being half white. And he rejected that, the whiteness. And the lady goes, it was the white part that had killed him, man. Like, if he had a black dad, he wouldn't have got melanoma.
Is that true?
I don't know if it's true, but that's what the lady said.
Do black people get melanoma? I kind of know, right?
You know what? I didn't look it up, but I just assumed that the former Jamaican model knew what she was talking about.
I'm gonna look that up.
It was a white part that it was a white.
Let's see how much I. So do black people into Google? Do black people need sunscreen?
It am the white part that done killed him, man. The white part that he hated so much, it done killed him.
Yes, everyone can get skin cancer.
There was another great thing in there where, like, apparently...
That's so cute. Yes, everyone can get skin cancer.
Apparently...
fucking idiots. Sorry, I just... Like, it's just, like, such a stupid question. Yes, you moron. Everyone can get skin cancer.
So...
Sorry.
Bob Marley's dad was, like, an old... They called him the captain. And he was... Apparently, he just, like, going around impregnating young black women. Because he, like... At one point, they're interviewing this lady. And she's, like... She's talking to Bob Marley's wife. And, you know, Bob Marley's wife says, hey, I'm... You know, I'm Rita Marley. And then... The other lady goes, that ain't my last name too, man. I didn't know there was any other Marleys. The only Marley I know is the captain. And the Bob Marley's wife goes, him father the captain. And he goes, me father the captain. So he had like siblings and he never knew.
Oh, yeah.
Like he was just walking down the street and run into somebody that was his half brother, half sister.
So this guy was a ship captain?
No, I don't know what he was. They said he owned like a tuna business, so maybe he was a captain in the army or something, and then just went to
It'd
Jamaica.
Be funny if there were no black Marleys until this one guy came along.
And that's what they said too. They said Bob Marley done made the Marley name, and no one heard of the captain. They heard of Bob Marley. Anyway, I don't know. So... I watched the whole thing, so there you go. It's fun. I would love if it wasn't super violent and that they didn't hate, you know, tourists and stuff. I would love to go to, like, just move to Jamaica and become a Rastafarian and grow some big old dreadlocks and get start working on me Jamaican accent, man. And one guy, man, it was so good. He was just like, he's like him going on to the thing that got butt. And you could hear English words every once in a while, and you'd just be like, man. And they had to put up the closed captioning so you could get the subtitles. It was great.
Was it Ziggy? Was that Ziggy?
No, it was just some, like, local, you know, some local. Ziggy is like, he grew up with wealth. He ain't talking all that shit. Anyway, it's on Netflix if you want to watch it.
I do want to watch it. Thank you very much.
It was good. But you know, a lot of stuff about, like, when he was dying and stuff, like, I didn't know all that. Like, I never looked up all the stuff where he was dying. He didn't just die, man. He had a
slow... So I didn't know. I mean, I knew he died of cancer, but that's as far as it goes.
He had a slow, awful death. And they said, they wanted the, he got the melanoma on his toe, and they said, look, let's just cut off the toe and you'll be fine. But then they said he wouldn't be able to play football, which is what the rest of the world calls soccer. And so he was like...
he was a professional soccer player.
But he's like, I got to play soccer.
It's like...
Who, Bob
Marley? It's like, cut the damn toe off, man. Right. I'm a singer.
He
what do
loves
I need that shit
football,
for?
Man. He was like, I got to play football. Just do something else. So they cut it out, and then he never fucking followed up. He just cut off the bit and just like, he was like, that's it, I'm not going back. I'm not going to check it, no way, man. And the guy was like, had he gone to the doctor one time, they could have found out that the cancer had spread and they could have saved him. But he never went back.
Or just cut the toe off, right? Like,
so after...
Like if he had cancer in his hand... I get it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, you can't play guitar or something. I mean,
he
I would still do it.
Throw,
it was, yeah,
like,
I would still do it, no doubt. But I'd at least understand. But it's like, it's toe. Like, it's freaking toe.
And it wasn't
There's
even like.
There's people that play soccer that have no legs.
And that was the thing. It wasn't like the doctor said he couldn't play football. His friends were like, you won't be a good footballer. And he was like, man,
no.
It's peer pressure. It was peer pressure, man. Peer pressure is a motherfucker. Oh.
That's like that South African guy that killed his wife.
Yeah.
Like, he was a sprinter and he had no legs. You telling me that Marley can't play soccer with one less toe?
He'd have been fine. He could have got a fake toe. He got money. Well, he didn't have money at the time. But then, so he died, and the doctor said, finally, he collapsed on the stage, and the doctor said, listen, you're gonna fucking die. You're done. Like, you let it go, you're done. You're dead. And, like, so the Jamaican model was like, you don't come down back to Jamaica, let's smoke a big fat bliff, spliff, and we could just hang out to play music. And he was like, so they convinced him to go to a holistic doctor in Germany.
Oh, no.
Oh, my God. So he spent the rest of his life paying some dumbass bullshit, just giving him money. Like, here, you got bullshit, here, some money. Take my money for your bullshit. Anyway, oh, God.
Sad.
Other than that, though, I haven't done anything.
You know what? Like, honesty, probably was better for his career to die that young.
You know what?
Right?
Bob Marley, he had a pretty good head on his shoulder, except for the not going back to the doctor about his cancer thing. Except for that.
Or not getting his toe cut off.
Not listening to the doctor.
But think about Michael Jackson. Like, what would Michael Jackson's legacy have been if he would have died before he
got
turned
all the weird
white
plastic surgery and molested kids?
Yeah. Yeah, like if it was right after Thriller and then he just died of cancer. What he would have been like the
there'd be awards named after him and stuff. Michael Jackson,
right.
Lifetime Achievement Award goes to. But you can't do that when you're a child molester. You can't have a child lifetime achievement award named after a child molester.
I think that he probably does have awards named after him.
Yeah, but it's the ones you never hear
so
of.
So even then, even though he's a child molester, right, he still has awards named after him. Imagine what it would
have
been like
he'd had some good awards named after him, like of things you've heard of.
Right. I don't know.
Maybe
it did Bob Marley a favor to
when I was a
to
kid,
die as young as he did. On top.
When I was a teenager, getting smoking weed stuff, people would say, spoke to the distrust of the government. He said Bob Marley went into the hospital with the flu and he came out dead. Like, no facts.
Okay.
Like, it was just like, don't trust the government, man. Like, they killed him because he smoked too much pot. Oh shit, good times. Anyway. Poor Bob Marley. But that's it. I acquired birthday presents for both Randy and Mike this past week. Even though your birthday is not until like 6 months away.
Yeah, like
5 months away.
Wow.
So I got it. I got it. And Randy too. Randy's birthday is not until December 26th. And I got his birthday present. That's why I told him to call me, because it's sitting out. If he was coming over, I was going to hide it. But I forgot. Well, I forgot. I didn't know we were doing a podcast tonight. So I told him he could come over.
Yeah, if that guy.
Anyway. Oh, man. Look at my beard, Mike. Look how long it's getting.
I can't see it. Somebody told me to turn off the video.
Probably a good idea, because you sound like shit sometimes. So let's move on with this show, everybody. This week, Mike says, what are we going to watch? And I don't know why this popped in my head. Actually, I do know why. Because I have here something I'm going to give away. And it's related to the show we watch. And this is just a one-week giveaway. And it's one of those things, if you want it. This is the contest. If you want it, send an email and you get Knight Rider, complete season 1 on DVD. Complete with Goodwill sticker, $5.
So wait a second. Is this how you watched our episode that we just
watched?
No,
this is brand new, man. This is unopened.
Oh, okay. All right.
I'm giving it away. If you want to send an email to cartoonretrocast@gmail.com, say, I want the Knight Rider Season 1 DVD, and it's yours. I'll mail it out to you. Oh, include your address. First one that gets it, gets it.
Gets it.
So...
don't stop, get it.
In case you don't know, we're watching Knight Rider. Don't stop, get it. Get them down, do Tootsie Roll.
Tootsie Roll, that's right. Tootsie Roll. I don't know who sings it, but Quad City DJs? No.
No, 90, no. I was going to say 95 South, but that's that. Whoop, there it is. Let me see that.
69 Boys? 60. I actually had no idea that that was who sang it.
I've heard of that. I've heard of that. So this week, Mike, we're watching Knight Rider, a little show from the 80s. And Mike said, what are we watching? I said, I just happened to buy a DVD at the Goodwill, and I want to give it away. So that's what we're going to watch.
Yep. Let's do it.
Let's do it. So let's... That's a badass theme song.
So there is a little part... I don't know what you played, but there is a little part before that.
I just played like the song. Industries. Yeah, I didn't play the whole the intro. Just the theme.
Right.
Light Industry. Light Industries 2000.
So let me just say something real quick about Knight Rider. Is that I watched the show when I was a kid. I thought it was amazing.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't remember anything about it. I doubt that I ever watched even a full episode. Because, like, I'm not watching non-cartoons when I'm 5 years old. So I'm going to be really interested to hear Jeremy Reed's Wikipedia.
Knight Rider.
I have a lot of misconceptions about Knight Rider that now I'm confused about. Like, what?
Knight Rider was like a cartoon, man. That show was badass. I watched the shit out of Knight Rider.
But did you know? See, I thought... All right, here's this one misconception I had that was cleared up in this episode. I thought that Michael Knight invented... Kit.
No, Michael Knight was a cop, and he was left to die on the side of the road, and that guy, the English guy, I forget his name, found him and brought him back to life, and then gave him a new face because he looked completely different. You don't remember any of this?
No.
Oh,
I remember
man.
The car. I remember the car would run people you're down.
With the time to use the turbo booster, Michael.
That's what I'm saying, is that... I don't remember anything about Knight Rider other than Knight Rider was a cool car that was like a supercar. It was like Airwolf, but it was a car.
Air Rider.
Worse than Airwolf. But.
So, oh man. So me and my brother, I'll get to reading Wikipedia in a second. My brother and I had matching Knight Rider big wheels had fucking windshields on them. And I'm pretty sure it had an e-brake. So you could do a spin out or something when you're coming down a hill. Skip it! Lock up them brakes. Spin out. Had a windshield, man. Not too many kids had big wheels with windshields. And they bought us... I remember, and I wish I still had the box. They took the boxes and put them in our spare... We had a spare bedroom. And the closet, my dad put his beer can collection in it. In the Knight Rider boxes. Knight Rider big wheel boxes. That should be the phrase that pays. Knight Rider big wheel, everybody.
All right. Knight Rider Big Wheel boxes or just Knight Rider Big Wheel?
Just Knight Rider Big Wheel. That's it.
Knight Rider Big Wheel. I'm going to look it up, actually.
It was awesome. I remember it had, like,
really cool.
The stickers in the front, and it had the little red band. I mean, obviously, it didn't light up and shit, but it had the little red stripe in the front, because the front of the big wheel was shaped like the hood of a car, the hood of a Trans Am. Yeah.
Yep.
Oh, man, it was so awesome. I love that big wheel. Big wheels were fucking durable, too. They were just blow mold plastic, man. Like, the wheels would get, like, roughed up, but that's it. Like, they were just, like, tanks, like miniature tanks. Love that fucking big wheel. I wish I still had it to this day. I'd be out there riding it right now instead of doing a podcast. So, all right, so Mike wants to know a little bit Jeremy Reed's Wikipedia, everybody. This week, we're watching Knight Rider. Knight Rider, Mike, is an American television series created and produced by Glenn A. Larson. The series originally broadcast on NBC from 1982 to 1986. And I'm sure I wasn't watching it in 1982, but by, like, 1984, 85, 86, I was there. The show stars David Hasselhoff as Michael Knight, a high-tech modern crime fighter assisted by Kit, an advanced, artificially intelligent, self-aware, and nearly indestructible car. This was the last series Larson devised. Whatever, who cares about that shit?
So what did Kit stand for?
Kit stands for...
Does it say?
It does stand for... Or it does say...
Knight Industries...
2000. Yeah. Knight Industries 2000, everybody. So the premise of Knight Rider, in case someone listening doesn't know, or Mike, who just didn't watch it, Self-made billionaire Wilton Knight rescues police detective Lieutenant Michael Arthur Long after a near-fatal shot to the face. Ooh, TV premises.
So that's not the British guy, right?
No, that was Michael Knight got shot in the face. But he was Michael Long.
No, the British guy is not Wilson Knight.
Wilton Knight. Yes.
Well, yeah. Who's Wilton Knight? Wilton Knight's the British guy, or no?
No. Okay. Wilton Knight was the guy who owned Knight Industries. Devin Miles is the British guy.
All right.
All right. gives him a new name.
Go on.
After getting premises to shows used to be a lot brutal. He got shot in the face and left for death. They give him plastic surgery, give him a new name, a new face, Michael Knight. Wilton selects Michael to be the primary field agent in the pilot program of his public justice organization, the Foundation for Law and Government, FLAG. The other half of this pilot program is the Knight Industries 2000 kit, a heavily modified, technologically advanced Pontiac Firebird Trans Am. Bitchin', man! With numerous features, including an extremely durable shell and frame, controlled by a computer with artificial intelligence, Michael and Kit are brought in during situations where direct action might provide the only feasible solution. Heading FLAG is Devin Miles, who provides Michael with directives and guidance. Dr. Bonnie Barstow is the chief engineer in charge. There's a woman in the STEM industries. She doesn't get her due.
There you go.
It's the chief engineer in charge of Kit's care, as well as technical assistant to Devin. April Curtis fills this role in season 2. The car, the famous car Kit, is a series of customized 1982 Pontiac Trans Am sports model that costs U.S. $100,000 to build, equivalent to $8 billion in 2014. Nose, dash, and other interior of the car were designed by the design consultant Michael Schiff. So after we watched this episode, Mike, I went and looked it up. You can buy a 1982 Trans Am and paint it black and shit and have it pretty much look like Kit, you know, stock as it is. But you could buy like the little interface and stuff on eBay, and then you could rig up the car to look like it.
The interior.
It gets expensive fast, though.
Auto drive.
Well, you can. I mean, it has like the buttons. I mean, I don't know if you can make your car auto drive.
Well, yeah, no, of course, it's not gonna drive around. But
it was like $400 or $500.
Have that durable shell, which is probably not safe for the person riding in it.
What do you mean, man? It's fine. You ever heard of
like
inertia dampers? That was in there. He's fine. Michael Knight's fine.
He's fine.
So, as we know, David Hasselhoff is Michael Knight. Kit, voiced by who, Mike? The guy.
I don't know. The guy from Boy Meets World.
Boy Meets World's principal, William Daniels.
Yeah, William Daniels. There you go.
Nobody else knows any of these other people. Now the reason why I picked this episode, originally I picked the second episode of with Carr in it, where Carr comes back from the dead. I was like, wait a minute, because the voice wasn't right. I was like, wait a minute, did they change the voice? I looked it up and they did. In the episode we watched, Trust Doesn't Rust, where Carr, K-A-R-R, Knight Automated Roving Robot, is discovered in a warehouse somewhere, is locked up, is voiced by none other than Optimus Prime, Peter Cullen.
Right.
And I watched this episode before, and I think I posted it in the Diamond Elite, because I thought in this episode he the car picks up two bums, and he's like, do you want, I know what humans want, they want to eat. And the guy's like, yeah, we like to eat. Like, you want to drink? And he's like, yeah, we love to drink. You want to reproduce? And they're like, oh, okay.
Yeah.
I guess we'd want to do
that. The other guy who was in this was Larry.
What do you mean, Larry?
It's like, hi, my name's Larry. It's my brother Daryl, my other brother Daryl.
Oh, I don't know. Who was that?
He was one of the dumb
bums.
Oh,
the dumb, yeah, okay. Okay.
But the skinny one, the small one, he was in Newhart. You remember that?
I do.
My name's Larry. It's my brother Daryl, my other brother Daryl.
How do you remember that much about Newhart, but not goddamn...
I don't know.
Knight Rider. So, Trust Doesn't Rust is the episode we watched, Mike. There were, looks like, 4 full seasons, 22, 24,
22
episodes.
Wait a second. Trust Doesn't Rust. This was like the 9th episode.
90 episodes of Knight Riders were made, yes.
No, no, But this episode was like one of the first ones.
Right. It was the first season.
So it must have been like 1982.
Right.
Was he Optimus Prime yet? He wasn't Optimus Prime yet.
No, I don't think so.
Because Transformers 1984, right? I think.
Let's see.
I don't know, Michael. Let me look it up.
Transformers.
I think he doesn't give the date. Whatever.
Transformers TV.
I'm a car.
1984, it's 2 years.
So
this is Peter Cullen's debut of the Optimus Prime voice.
He goes from playing a car to playing a transforming truck. He's like, you're moving up. He's like, his agent calls me. Listen, Peter. He's like, hello? Peter, listen, this is your agent. I know you just did that voice of the car. What do you think about this? Voice of a truck.
Let me think about it. All right, let's roll out.
Roll out, yeah. Use that in the show, in the audition. Roll out.
Yeah.
Anyway, so...
it's my robot voice. My robot voice.
I'm ready to roll out to the interview.
He was on GoBots too, right? Wasn't Peter Cullen also on GoBots? I think GoBots?
He was on everything.
Didn't we figure that out when we watched GoBots?
So we watched the episode, Mike. That episode originally aired on November 19th, 1982. Anyway.
All right, let's move on from these songs. These songs are a bust.
All night long.
We're dying.
All night long. That's a Lionel Richie song. All night.
Yeah, I do like that one.
That's a good one.
I like that one. Actually, let's just talk about Lionel Richie songs that I like. Hold on.
Top 10 songs.
Dancing on the Ceiling.
Never heard of it, so how'd it go?
What? You never heard of Dancing on the Ceiling?
I said, how'd it go? Maybe I heard it.
Where you're dancing on the ceiling. And then they turn in the music video, they turn the room upside down.
I never heard of that shit.
Come on. Let's see. Hello?
Hello?
Okay.
Hello?
Yeah, hello?
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 I think you sat on your mute button.
No, I'm telling you, hello.
Oh, hello.
So, Lionel Richie song I like, hello.
Nah, I name some songs that other people have heard.
It's the one with the blind girl.
Oh, shit, Mike, I messed up. I didn't cover up my trash for you. I'm gonna do that. So you don't get upset.
Hello. I don't know. I can't find any. It was just those two, I guess.
All right, everybody. What about that song? All night long. All night.
Yeah.
That's a good one.
That one. That's it.
That's it.
All Night Long and Dancing on the Ceiling are the two I like.
All right. That's fine. Everybody's got to like
that's enough.
Two different stuff. All right.
I think that's plenty. Come
on. So the episode
he was also in the right? Wasn't he in the Commodores, or am I thinking of somebody else?
I don't know, man. I don't know. I've never heard of that.
You've never heard of the Commodores before?
I've heard of the Commodores, but I never heard that Lionel Richie was in it.
Yeah, he was.
All right. They learn something new every day. So,
And then they had the Brickhouse song. There you go.
The episode we watched, titled Trust Doesn't Rust, Mike, stars... Or it's about...
Colors don't run.
All right, so we got the premise of Knight Rider. Michael Knight and Kit go out and dish out vigilante justice when it's the last resort. I don't know if they're officially backed by the government. Flag has government in the name. I don't know if they're like an arm of the government or a contractor of the government, or they operate in their own...
He had to get a call in from the... The guy was friends with, like, the district attorney or something to get him released. Because in the episode, he accidentally gets arrested.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Because
they think he's car. And right. Then when he gets out, he says, oh, good thing you made the call. You talked to your friend in the district attorney's office and got us released.
Yeah, I remember that.
So
my favorite part of that...
Otherwise, they wouldn't have had to do that. So
car... Wait a minute. Did we watch the same episode?
Oh my god. Yeah, the one with the two guys that break into the facility.
Right. Okay. All right.
And then Carr, and then they take him for a ride.
I also watched the other episode, which is when Carr comes back to life. In that episode, right? So a kid, somebody in their 20s finds Carr. And I know I'm talking about an episode we didn't watch, but I got to tell you this. So the Carr, like the guy doesn't know that Carr is artificially intelligent. So he's driving on. Carr takes over and he starts driving like crazy, 85 miles an hour. So the cop sees him, goes out after him, but of course Carr is blowing the cop away. Meanwhile, Michael Knight has been tracking Carr's signal, and Carr blows past Michael Knight and Kit. So hurry up, Kit jumps out before the cop car, but after Carr. It's the same looking car, right? The two black Trans Ams. Well, Carr uses a turbo booster, jumps over a train. Kit is like, Michael's like, do we have enough space to execute the turbo booster? And Kit's like, I'm sorry, Michael. We do not have enough space. So he stops. And then a cop comes up, and he's like, the cop gets out, and he's like, get your hands on the car. So Michael Knight gets out. He's like, whoa, take it easy, buddy. We're on the same side. So he's like, this isn't the car you're looking for. Just look at the license plate. My car says Kit. The car you're looking for, the license plate says Car. And the guy's like, get your hand on the top of the roof. Come on now. That's the only difference. Like, I thought it was funny.
That's funny because you'd think an 80s show, it would have just been like, oh, the license plate's different. All right.
Let's go after the other guy. Is the cop like walks behind a car and looks down? He's like, you know what? I didn't see that. You're right. I did not see that. That says Kit, the K-I-T-T. I did not see that. When another car blew by me at 85 miles an hour, I did notice that it said K-A-R-R. So you're right. All right, you're free to go. You want me to clear out these people so you can do a terror boost over the train? No. All right. I'm just asking. But you're right. So that I just thought that was funny. But the episode we watched, was it the two bums that broke into the place?
Yeah.
So two bums break into...
Right. And like, by the way, bums, right? Like,
they're hobos.
At first... Yeah, they're hobos. At first I was like, what? Why? What are they doing? And then... I realized, no, I must have misread something. They're probably just criminals, like regular criminals.
Well, they are criminals, but they're also bums.
No, I know, but I was like... Oh, why are these, you know, in my mind, I said, oh, there's two bums. They're just looking for something, you know, a place to stay. But then they broke in and they were like, oh, we're going to get all this high tech equipment to sell. And I was like, maybe I misunderstood something and they're just regular, you know, corporate espionage criminals.
And they're just two dopes.
And then, and then afterwards, you know, they come in and. We'll talk about it, but like then they leave, and then they wake up in Carr, and they're like drunks, and I'm like, okay, I didn't misread that. They were hobos. What the hell just happened?
And I like the high tech equipment they were going to steal were like those big giant reel to reel data tape backups and stuff.
where do you unload that as a hobo?
You just like you do that
the trade card. You know,
they do that thing where they open their trench coat and they're like, I got your 1 megabyte backups right here. 1 megabyte backups. Get a cheap $8,000, 1 megabyte backup.
I thought I knew that I misunderstood what was going on, and then I was like, nope, you didn't misunderstand it. It's just weird.
So Carr was the original prototype for the Carr of the future.
Right.
Unfortunately, Mike Wilton Knight, who had created Carr and Kit, designed Carr as self-preservation as his main function.
Right.
He has no interest in making sure other people, like humans, survive. He has to survive. So that was early on in the testing, realized that's a flaw. And instead of just rewriting the code or, you know, wiping that EPROM chip and starting over, they just locked him in a closet with... A closet room where two
the funny thing too is that
two hobos could just stumble in on.
Now the other funny thing too is that he wants to help people.
He does, right? A problem?
He wanted to help them. He was just like, but when it comes down to me or you, I'm going to choose me
every time.
I get that.
Every time, me or you, it's me.
Yeah. But he was more than happy to help everybody.
Yeah, he was trying to help. He was trying to help.
He didn't have to. He could have just... He wasn't evil.
Well, he was evil by design.
I guess. I don't know.
So, nobody knows that Carr... Like, Michael Knight's not aware of Carr. Kit's not aware of Carr. In fact, when Carr comes out of the closet, literally, not figuratively... Get your mind out of the gutter. He starts chasing after Michael, and Michael's like, "Whoa, Kit, what are you doing?" But it wasn't Kit. It was Carr.
Wait, did he think it was Kit?
I thought he thought it was Kit.
No, I thought he just... I thought that he grabbed the security guard and rolled out of the way just immediately, and then I don't know.
Maybe you're right.
Because I remember Kit saying, "Michael, did you see that car? He looked like me." And he's like, "Except for one difference. That car tried to kill me."
Why is your version of Kit like an effeminate guy?
That's what he sounds like.
Hey, Michael. Hello, Michael. Hey, Michael. What's going on? That jacket looks awesome.
Hello, Michael.
Kit. So now Carr, like the two hobos escaping Carr. I don't know if they black out or something in Carr.
Yeah, how did they get into the car?
Maybe they like jumped in there to hide. I can't remember. But they woke up and
it wasn't.
So here's an interesting fact that I didn't know until this episode. Or not know, but didn't remember or didn't notice. The original Kit's voice modulator or voice meter was just a red square. So when he talked, it kind of pulsated, like on and off. Right. Carr had the volume meter that would go up and down as he spoke.
Right.
It was like a peak meter. And they took that from Carr and put it in Kit because it was cooler. Later on, after this episode.
Oh, I didn't realize that either.
Yeah, so later on, like Kit's voice meter looks more like Carr's. Because they probably just thought, like, they probably have two Kits, right? One, like, you know, whenever you
they
make something.
They have six Kits.
Oh, yeah, whatever.
They really had seven Kits or whatever.
Yeah, you can't just have one in case something goes wrong. So you have a bunch of them. Plus, you can also shoot, like, you can go out and shoot. You could have two units shooting. You could have, like, highway shooting, units shooting, and you could have, like, the main principal actors shooting at the same time, cutting calls, cutting time, or saving time. Anyway. So they're probably like, hey, let's make this episode with this car. We'll call it Carr. Looks like Kit. And, I forgot where I was going with that. But anyway, so that's the thing. It's like, when you... They probably thought Kit was like Carr was gone. Like they were like, "Hey, we'll just do this." But then they were like, "We've run out of ideas. We've already made 60 episodes. Let's make another Carr. Let's bring him back from the dead."
Here's a nice little from the book, little snippet from the book Knight Rider Legacy. The stunt work was hard on for Carr's. Wait, what? The stunt work was hard on. Oh, was hard on the Carr's.
There you go.
And the show typically ruined 4 to 9 each season. The Trans Ams were sold by GM to the producers for $1 each. Each one cost about $18,000 to modify into Kit.
There you go. Well, we just read it cost $100,000.
Well, $200,000.
Maybe they meant for all of them.
So,
I mean, it was definitely advertising for GM.
How many seasons were there? There was like
four seasons.
7 seasons.
4 seasons.
So there was like 60 Kits.
60 Kits, yeah. I mean, like I said, the cars aren't too far off. In fact, I owned. GM called them F bodies. They made up the Pontiac Trans Am, the Chevy Camaro, and the other one. What is it? The Firebird? No, was it Firebird Trans Am? Anyways, there's three different car makes. Can you remember Chevy used to just make a shit ton of different cars, like. Remember there used to be like 1,000 different makes of cars? But it was all like, no. It was really like only like 10 different makes of different cars. They just rebranded them and all kinds. Anyway, so the Chevy Camaro and the Trans Am and the Firebird, they were all basically the same, but they were a little bit different and they were sold to different people based on those looks. So I had an 86 At one point, I had an 86 Camaro. And it looked pretty much, although Trans Ams and I think Firebirds had the lift up retractable headlights so they would go up and go down. The Camaro did not have that. Camaros always had their headlights.
Right, so you had a third gen Chevrolet Camaro.
Yes.
Which is the same body as the Pontiac Firebird.
Firebird, yeah. And
without the lift up lights and the Firebird.
Right. And the Camaro taillights wrapped around the back of the rear of the vehicle, and the Pontiacs, they would stay flat, like flush with the rear. But they were very similar cars. Nice car. I wish I still had that car, actually. It was cool. It sucked in the snow, though, because it was rear-wheel drive and had those big, fat tires. Like, I didn't have the 8-cylinder. I had a 6-cylinder, but it was still pretty cool.
Did it have the turbo boost?
It did not have turbo boost. It also did not have T-tops, which I was glad about because they leak when it rains. Anyway, so Carr wants to help the hobos, and the hobo, like, the first thing he does is takes them to, like, a jack-in-a-box type of restaurant. Like,
yeah.
It's just like they call it the Three Rings.
Three Ring. That's it. It's like a Three Ring circus.
So they go up to order, and the one hobo is like, man, he's like, I want some breakfast. And the guy on the speaker is just like, I'm sorry, sir, we're not serving breakfast right now, we're serving lunch. And the guy's like, then I don't know what I want. And the guy on the box is just like, well, could you hurry up, sir? We got a line building up or something, you know, like he's getting impatient. And Carr was like, listen to the sound of his voice. He's getting impatient. What a jerk. What a dickhead.
He's saying like, I do not believe that this person is inside of that machine. I am getting radio signals showing that he is somewhere else. And they're like, what are you talking about?
Look, just calm down. We're going to order a cheeseburger. Wait, just wait.
It is funny, though. He was like, I will go get you something I will get you some food. But they didn't have money. Yeah,
but I know Kit could print money.
Okay, so maybe he could print money. I don't know.
They didn't talk about it episode.
Because they went robbing places. So.
I'm just saying that I know an episode. I've seen an episode of Knight Rider where Michael Knight was going to go gamble or something, and he's like, Kit, I need in a couple hundred. And it's just like, and spits out a couple hundred bucks. I don't know if it's real money or if it's counter. I don't know if he's just like an ATM where he just has money stored inside of him.
Yeah, maybe that was it. He just has a couple hundred thousand stored inside of him.
But, next to the radiator in a box.
But I just thought it was funny that... So I was like, okay, so what's the end game here? Is that they're just going to start robbing things by just having this car
drive
that is
going to
just crash into storefronts? And that's exactly
what happened. He drove through the drive-through box guy, the clown or whatever, and then they were like, he can drive through stuff, can he?
Right, like, oh, this car is durable. So we'll just crash into a jewelry store and then rob it. I'm like, that's not the most efficient way.
It works, though, it works.
I guess. And then they could outrun the cops. That was the other thing, is that, you know, the car's so fast and nimble that they run cops.
But the whole time, Carr is also, like, they mentioned Kit, and Carr is like, that is an inferior model. It is a production model. I am the prototype. So he must be inferior.
He gets a little pissed off.
Yeah, he gets a little jealous. So, but eventually, you know, the hobos are robbing places, and they're like, we just need one, they always need one big score. We just need one big score.
They're going to live on a beach.
They're going to live on a beach in Rio de Janeiro. And then Carr is like, there's a problem. My unit requires maintenance because I am a prototype. And so they didn't know how, so the lead guy, the serious guy, there's a serious guy and like a jokey guy. The serious guy was like, he's like, listen, man, we're going to play a joke on, we're going to trick this car. I'm going to say we're going to give him a new spark plug, change his oil, give him some brake pads, and ultimately we're just going to use him to do this last score, and then we're going to ditch him. And the other guy's like, yeah, that's a good idea. But meanwhile, Carr has used some sort of, like, infrared or something. He can see through the wall.
Sensors. sensors could hear them. It's like the robot in 2001 reading lips.
So he knew what was going on. But then, like, so the jokey guy, jokey hobo, thought he was double-crossing Carr, but then he ended up double-crossing the jokey guy, the other hobo.
Right.
It was a double-double-cross, triple-cross. And so, like, he ends up kidnapping. First, he fucking kills the one hobo. He murders him.
Oh, he doesn't.
He does.
He lived.
What?
Oh, he lived.
No, why did Carr say, I don't remember him living, because Carr said, are you going to terminate my functions like you terminated the other hobo's functions? I don't think he lived. I don't remember seeing him again. He did not live. Because then that guy went and kidnapped the female STEM lady.
Right.
And was going to force her to fix up Carr. And he just, like, got distracted while he was killing the other guy. And she just, like, got out and left.
Yeah. That definitely happened.
Yeah.
She got out and left. And then, like, I don't recall how Michael Knight knew where they were. But then Kit just crashed through the wall. Remember how he figured out where they were? Were they tracking Carr or something like that?
I don't remember. You know, it's one of those things.
And then there's just a car chase. And then they play chicken. And then they're thinking about the immovable object versus the unstoppable force.
And even Kit's like, he's like, I cannot allow you to do this, Michael. I'm going to take over autopilot. And Michael's like, no, you're not. Boop. And hits the manual button again. Because he was playing chicken with him. And even the lady was like, you're crazy. You're going to kill us both. And then at the last second, Carr swerves and drives off a cliff and explodes.
He drives off a cliff and goes up in a fireball.
Now listen, because he landed in the ocean too and blew up in a fireball in the ocean. Not to mention that if you go back, Mike, and you watch the episode, the car that went off the cliff was like a 1962 Studebaker. It was not.
Oh, so they didn't wreck a.
It was not a Pontiac Trans Am or whatever it was, Firebird. It was not. It was just some stock footage they had from a fucking Charlie Chaplin movie. And so that's why I thought it was weird that they brought Carr back to life, because he blew up in a fireball in the ocean. But that was not enough to kill Carr.
Well, did they just? I mean, spoiler for me because I'm not going to watch it. But how did he come back? Did
so reference that? There's a guy and his old lady are on the beach with a metal detector, and he's like, the guy's like, beep beep beep. Beep, 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 beep. He's like, whoa, something over here. And he starts brushing, like, an inch under the sand. He starts brushing off. He's like, it's a car! And it was a 1982 Pontiac Trans Am in perfect mint cherry condition. That, it was just in the sand. It's buried.
Well, all right, here's what we do, right? Because he blew up.
He blew up.
But he didn't really blow up.
Nope.
Like, there was just a fireball. His frame is indestructible. So that's what happened.
Maybe he just, like, he detonated the fireball to make them think he blew up. Maybe he didn't, like, he blew up.
And then he buried himself in the sand.
And then buried himself in the sand, just like, you know, like, back and forth, like he walked in and back and forth, like, just real fast. I thought for sure, I was like, no way, I had an 86 Camaro, which is basically the same car, and I would never take that car on the beach. I would be so afraid that I would never be able to get out.
Yeah, but your car's not retrofitted with that stuff.
With the turbo boosters. I guess so. I mean, I guess if my car had a turbo booster, I might take it on the beach. But I thought, like, there's no way they're getting that car on the beach. I had that car. It ain't getting out of there.
Or an indestructible frame.
So, there you go. That's the episode titled Rust.
Awesome.
Trust Doesn't Rust. And it was awesome, Mike. I agree. So much fun. I loved it.
You messaged me and you said, look, it's an hour. I mean, it was, you know, whatever.
45
it's an
minutes.
Hour show. Yeah. So it's like 45 minutes. Like, are you going to be able to handle this? And I was like, look, it's not a cartoon. I'll be able to handle it just fine.
I don't like.
And I did.
I don't like to overbear or overwhelm, like, with too much cartoon. too many cartoons. Too much homework.
Yeah.
Lest he get pissed off or, you know.
It was great. I had a much more enjoyable time watching this than I did watching that Scooby-Doo episode. You know what? I didn't even make it through the Scooby-Doo episode. I cut out after like 10 minutes. I'm like, I can't do this anymore.
You got to give him more chance. Because my girlfriend and I, we laid here and watched on Netflix, they have She-Ra. We watched the first like 10 episodes of She-Ra. It wasn't that bad. It wasn't that bad.
I just have other stuff that I need to do. Like
Yeah.
Yelling, hair.
Yelling at old ladies.
Yelling at, well, somebody's rubbing off on me.
Shut up, you old fat bitch!
who yells at people, though, for...
White people, man. That's what they do.
Yeah. All right. What was our word again? Our phrases of pace?
Knight Rider Big Wheel.
Knight Rider Big Wheel, everybody.
So that's your last, this is your last, if you're listening to this, the sounds of our voices, what is today? Today is, we're recording this on Saturday, February 25th. This episode will come out 25th. Wednesday, March 1st.
A couple days. So March 3rd, somewheres in the evening, we will be recording our giveaway episode. I'm picking up the Switch on Friday in
this
the morning.
This is a good opportunity to mention our disclaimer again. If he cannot pick it up for whatever reason, Best Buy oversold it, gave it away, the Best Buy burned down, the truck blew up, whatever. If he cannot obtain it, the contest will have to be delayed until we can get one. We will get you your Switch, is what I'm saying. But if it's out of our control that we cannot obtain the Switch, it will not be given away until we can physically have it in our hands.
Right. And I have a Target order as well.
There you go.
But I don't know. It's sitting there. It just says not shipped yet. So, well, it's not going to be shipped now. But hopefully it'll be shipped at least on Thursday, you know, and then maybe get to me on Friday or Saturday. I don't know. I don't know how post office works. But like, comment, subscribe. Email us, Patreon us, whatever. Go to the YouTube video. What's the link for the YouTube?
CartoonRetrocast.com/YouTube.
Look for how to win a Nintendo Switch. We haven't been putting that many videos up.
I figured out my problem, and I uploaded episode that we recorded like a month ago. Finally got it encoded, and this one will be up there too. So,
and we'll put the and we'll do it live on Twitch, and the basic point is there's a lot of different ways to enter, and the more times you enter, the more chances you have of winning, because then you'll be in that many amount of pots. And I'm still shocked that not very many people have been emailing us. I think it's probably the harder thing, but I think it's, you know,
it's definitely the hardest six people. You have to sit through and listen.
You gotta sit through.
You actually have to listen to our dumbasses.
A lot of people have liked the post. A lot of people have commented. Although less people have liked than commented. I'm surprised that people haven't just commented with like a period. You know what I mean? Just so they can get in that comment field of, you know, because if we choose the comments, it's like 10 times less people than the amount of likes. So I don't know. Do what you got to do. But I mean, it's a Switch. It's going to somebody. There it is.
That's all it is. So I want to take this opportunity right now to mention that Lil Brian S. has a podcast called By the Bulb. They're giving away a cool, fully articulated Guardians of the Galaxy toy. What's that guy's name? You know, the guy.
You love Guardians of the Galaxy.
I don't love Guardians, but I'm just saying it's a cool-looking toy, and they're giving it away for free, and you know them things aren't cheap. What's that guy's name, the main guy? He's got a dumb name.
Oh, Stargazer.
Starblazer. He's got a cool name, I mean.
Star...
By the Bulb, go there and listen to that. Brian makes those awesome pictures with, like, real action figures, and he doctors them up with Photoshop, but they're, like, real pictures, and he's got an Instagram account over there.
Of toys.
Of toys. Yeah, toys. So he takes, like...
So, like...
He'll buy the higher quality toys. Not like, I mean, he does do some with like Ninja Turtles and stuff, but he buys like the, you know how they have like you know how they have like action figures made for the adult market, not pornography. I'm trying to say,
right?
You know what I mean? Just higher quality action figures made for not for kids.
I'm trying to look for. He had this cool one of He-Man on Thundercat. I don't know if that's Thundercat.
Battle Cat.
And I guess he had, I don't know, shoved it into the dirt, so the dirt's flying up. It's really good.
It's really good. So if you go over there, listen to his podcast, they're giving away a free toy. I also want to take this moment to talk, tell you guys to go listen to Classic Leet podcast. Those guys are great. And little Scott L, he's always talking up our show. He's been mentioning that we're giving away the Switch now on just about every episode that I've listened to. And they go live on Twitch too, and they do a good show. And they're basically my source for video game news.
New news.
Yeah, new video game news. At this point, I mean, they talk about old games, and they also play old games and stuff. They play live, do live playthroughs and stuff. So go listen to Classic Leet. Mike, how do you spell that?
Classic spelled L74HH48XOR.
No, come on.
Classic spelled like classic, L337.com, I think. But I think if you just type in Classic Leet,
into Google.
L-E-E-T into Google. It's like the third one down. So, yeah.
That's in there.
Well, I guess YouTube channel is in there, too.
L337, Classic Leet. That's a good show. Those are good guys. Go listen to their show. I don't think they're giving away anything other than quality entertainment. But yeah.
I mean, they could give away stuff if they wanted to. They get, they get stuff for free.
Yeah, I heard them talking about.
We don't get anything for free.
But what are we gonna get? Like, somebody's gonna.
I don't know. But they get shit for free. Like, they get games and stuff.
That's
they
what
can
I mean. Though it's not like they're gonna give us like, hey, will you guys watch this Muppet Babies DVD and then tell us what you think? No, come on.
They could give us games. Well, they could give us a Switch.
We don't talk. We're not a game podcast.
We are. Look at Twitch right now. Retrocast, a video game podcast. Boom.
All right,
that's it.
Well, now give me 1 second. Talk about something for a second, Mike. Talk about something. How nice was it in the what's it called? The Hawaii.
I don't know. It's all right.
Sorry. I mean, you did have to go with your family, so it couldn't have been that great.
I'm trying to think. Yeah, the real highlight was the yelling at the old lady.
Did you go back and see your dad and visit like?
Yeah, we saw my dad. We had two parties, one with relatives on one island, one with relatives on another island, and that was cool, man. You know, you get a party like that, people like to bring good food.
Was there any drinking or anything? Did you drink at all?
I had a couple beers at one of the parties.
That's a couple beers. My girlfriend says she wants to start drinking beer. She asked me what beer tastes like, and I told her it tastes like shit until you get used to it. And once you get used to it, it tastes pretty good.
That's not true. You could get her better tasting beers.
That's what I told her. I said, like, they have hundreds of beer. They have, like, sweet beer. Like, I drank a beer that was a root beer beer. It was root beer, but a beer. Anyway, let's wrap this show up.
Sweet beer. Wait a second. Wait, go back to that for 1 second. What the hell are you talking about? They put sugar in a beer?
It's root beer, but beer. It's like alcoholic root beer.
Well, okay, so you could get yourself a wine cooler, too.
No. This is beer that's a root beer.
No, that's like a wine cooler.
No, man, it's a beer. It's a beer with sugar and shit.
I didn't like beer all that much when I was a teenager and I was drinking it for the first time. But when I was later in life, so I was like a senior in high school.
2 years later.
Like somebody started, I mean, obviously people were doing this for a long time, but I didn't know about it. Somebody gave me a Corona with a lime in it.
Right.
And I was, wow, this actually doesn't taste like crap. And I know people don't like Corona. People are like, you know. But for me, as a teenager, who the only other beer I had was Coors Light, it was great. You know, very light. Doesn't have any taste. Just tasted like the lime.
I've loved beer since the day I've tasted it. And I grew up, when I was a teenager, I was drinking malt liquor, 40 ounces, Mickey, St. Ives, OE 800. I was drinking the worst of the worst, and I still love that. Although not, I can't drink
it. I drank those a lot in college. And that smell, that I don't know what it is, like a licorice smell or something. You know that smell.
St. Ives is very sweet. Like St. Ives. Did you ever drink St. Ives?
St. Ives, yeah. St. Ives?
St. Ives. The Ides of Mike.
St. Ides and OE's.
OE 800. And then we used to have big, when we were real broke, we get Mickey's Big Mouth. They weren't 40 ounces. They were 32 ounces, but they were like 89 cents for a 32 ounce beer back then.
I've told this story before, I think, to you, but maybe you don't remember. When I was in college, I went up to visit a friend.
Mm-hmm.
And stayed at his house, and so we started drinking at 8 a.m.
Right,
and he had this idea that, you know, he didn't want to get trashed by noon and like sleep, you know, at 1 p.m. So he was putting Red Bull into his OEs.
Red Bull?
Yeah,
I didn't even
Red Bull.
How long has Red Bull been around? I know they used to sell Red. They used to sell alcohol with Red Bull in it. The government had to put a stop to it because it was too awesome.
No, that was something different. But that was after we were doing this. I honestly, this is like, there's only a few times in my life where I thought I was going to die. And this was one of those times because my heart was racing and I felt sick.
Oh, I don't like the shit anyway, energy drinks. Anyway, let's wrap this show because now we're just babbling. All right, everybody. That's the show, everybody. Really big show. Let's talk about our random thanks, Mike. We got a new Patreon patron, Lil Eric K. Want to thank him for supporting the show. And as always, our Double Diamond Elite members, Eric T, Jared C, Mike M, Larry F, Lil Tim A, everybody. That's the show.
So wait a second. Do we have another Double Diamond Elite member that we don't know? Because maybe he signed up for the wrong level.
I don't know.
I think there's somebody at Elves Pit $5 a show.
Nope. We'll talk about that after the show. Come on, everybody!
The worst episode ever. Sit, boo-boo, sit. Good dog.